And tonight we will begin the process of rebroadcasting for the second time how storm cells move gold. This time, let me know if my audio is coming through loud and clear this time. I'm going to check with you right now, and please let me know what you see and hear, because that was not intended that way. It just came out that way. Sorry, but it happens. We just bounce and move along. There we are, how storms move gold. And I will look at the comments. We have three of them. So is the audio better? I will move along if I, oh, we got Bob, how you doing? Sound is good. Okay, so sorry, that was a technical snafu. That happens, especially when you're not wearing your headgear, but you know, it's, let me stop the live feed sound. Turn you down, and I will watch your comments there, and that way you guys can, you have had a chance to at least see a snippet of what I was going to talk about tonight. So we open the volley with this picture. This was a picture of a trip I was taking to drop my daughter off. Actually, I dropped her off earlier in the day, and then I came back down about 1 o'clock to go pick her up from her work. And what I saw on the way down was this picture. Now, this is about 4 miles north of where she works in Southern California here. And I am looking due east at what is essentially the Santa Monica Mountain Range, an area called Mount Boney. You can look it up on topo maps, and Newberry Park and Thousand Oaks, where the Woolsey Fire and the Hill Fire were all kind of conspiring to take out Newberry Park and other parts. Now, what you can see is a huge torrent of water dropping in that area. And so I'm going to talk a little bit about how these torrents form. And what I intended to do is to tell you a little bit about what I saw this afternoon. It's in the video I posted earlier talking about the water downpour that happened while I was 4 miles away getting a little tiny mist. The difference in amount of water in such a short distance was amazing. And you can see it in this picture, in this downpour. It's a torrential downpour. This is the kind of thing that will move gold. So I just kind of wanted to go back over that a bit. Let's take a look at another picture I have that kind of depicts what's going on here. So this is a full screen shot. Let me shrink my head a bit more so you can get a picture of what the picture tells you. I'm not that important. But what is important is to start. This is a timeline that starts at 0 minutes here, and you'll get droplets of water. That's kind of what I was getting down where I was south of here, and kind of what I was hearing from other people. Within about 5 or 6 minutes on the radio, they were announcing that the Grapevine, an I-5 that's going north from Los Angeles to the Central Valley and headed northern California, was closed in both directions, uphill both ways in the snow, because of snow. And it doesn't take much snow to close stuff here, but there can actually get some kind of black ice kind of stuff, so it's a mess. And when you get trucks that go on a 40% grade, or not 40, but on a 20% grade, and they're going for miles and miles, and they start sliding around, it's not fun. So they shut it down. So now what happens is we get into moderate precipitation zones, and that wasn't what we were seeing in that other picture. What we were seeing is moving from moderate to a strong precipitation. And while I was down in that parking lot waiting for my daughter to get out, I started hearing a zap, zap on the radio, the AM radio. Now, anytime you hear a zap, zap on AM radio, you should think of two things. One, lightning strikes, likely to be lightning and thunder nearby, but the frequency was about once every 10 seconds. That's a lot of lightning. Two, when you hear it that much lightning, or you start seeing white out on your television, used to be the old thing, that would indicate the possibility of tornadoes, because there's massive airflow circulation going on, and that comes into this strong precipitation, up current, down current, snow and ice moving around at the upper end of things. That's where the lightning's being generated, and droplets and huge torrents of rain. The huge torrents of rain is what I'm talking about here right now. Now, as it dissipates later, and this is like a 30-minute cycle here. So as it dissipates later, there isn't as much other than the winds and so forth. There may be some snow and some further precipitation, but the big torrents are in this section right here where it's just intense activity. This intense activity can bring 1 to 2 inches of rain in an hour. That much rain in a small zone, say 10 square miles or less, can cause massive floodings. We saw this in the fire up north in Santa Barbara, the Ventura and Santa Barbara area involved a year ago at the Thomas Fire. And a place called Montecito got one of these downfall, what they call supercells. So a zone, a small zone, literally several canyons wide, put so much water into that area that it took out some extra reservoirs and things like that immediately, causing a huge torrent of mud, boulders, etc., to shoot down into the town, and it killed 20 plus people. It also wasn't just the 20 plus people. It was moving boulders as big as houses right down through town, and down some of them got down onto the freeway, which was, like 4 miles away. So, and it filled up the freeway with mud and silt and stuff, and it overflowed and went on into the ocean. So this is the kind of thing that moves lots of gold. Well, whenever you see this, and I don't mean to make fun of that kind of tragedy, no question about it, it's dangerous, so stay away from it. And whenever you can, help with people and help them understand when something like this is starting to develop, one of these storms, to get up and out of the low areas because they're likely to flash flood. It's a danger. So, especially in the desert, be aware of that. Even if it's off and you're in the sunshine, if it's off and it's uphill in the canyons, upstream, know your riparian corridors, know those watersheds. Anything happening in that watershed is going to distribute to you sometime in the next hours. It could be in the next 10 minutes, but it could be hours later. After the storm seems to have disappeared, then the water comes rushing through. And it's surprise, you're gone. And all your vehicles and everything else are gone, and your camp's gone. So just be aware, that's a dangerous thing to have happen. So what you want to do is take advantage of knowing when you see these supercells move through that they are likely to generate flash floods that move mud and gold. That's the thing I wanted to talk about tonight. And so if you have any questions on this topic, give me a holler. I had mentioned government gold maps. What I wanted to mention in the context of this video wasn't that. It was, let's see if I could get this done right. Give you the right link to go to because this is important. Government gold maps is important for getting started, but this is important with respect to gold and water and how it moves gold. So that's what the 2020 is all about. Also, if you're interested, I have a page up there on the Sourdough Miner site. So sourdoughminer.com. Okay. There is a slash products slash, or you can pull on the product pull down. If you just go to sourdoughminer.com homepage, you can see a pull down there, or you can read any one of the articles or videos and watch them. Have fun. Share that with your friends. Share, by the way, share any of these videos on Facebook with your friends. Just hit the share button and shoot them out there. Like them, share them, let them know. Like the page. That way I can notify you that these videos are going live. Some people have complained that they don't see it. One of the things that can cause that, I'm not saying that's what's going on, but one of the things that can cause that is if you are familiar and you've been to the page, but you haven't liked the page, when I post things, don't have the ability to notify you that they're out there. But if you like the page, then anytime that happens, your news feed will pop up with a message coming from Hunting for Gold, and you get notified that there's a new live video going on. Come join. And share it with your friends. So this is our community. Hey guys, let me take a look at your comments. So let's see. Now it's good. Okay, we got lots of activity. So Shane says, thank you. You're welcome. Karen Beverly, thank you. Bob Sheely, North Carolina here. North Carolina. Check out the North Carolina Post. It's somewhere North Carolina and South Carolina are all combined in one post. I was going to split that on YouTube. I may yet in the future, but it's also posted on YouTube right now on Prospector Jess's channel. Subscribe to my channel and you can get access to those videos. It's on there. It's both North and South Carolina in one chunk, about 20 minutes, but kind of cover that whole area and a touch of Georgia to boot. Let's see, Bob Sheely, sound is good. Great. Karen Beverly says much better. Sorry about that, but that's what happens. We just move on. Everybody's saying yes, now it's good. So Bob Shealy says, had a good 3 days of rain here. Going to the creek this weekend, and I'm going to use some of tonight's info. Cool. That's what it's about. Get out there and get some gold. You know, without too much cheese. So great information, Jim Tripp. Thanks for from Morenci, Arizona. There we go. And then Pennsylvania, Brian Wright's checked in. He just got some 8 inches of snow there. That stuff, when it melts off, is gonna, depending on how it melts, it may or may not. So, for example, flood gold redeposits way too much on the Mississippi River, coming all the way down from, you know, North Dakota and through Fargo and all that stuff, where it floods like mad. Now, what does that do for you for prospecting? Well, it redeposits flood gold mainly. But if those things are moving in areas that have gold sources, load like the Sierra Nevada or the mountains in the Rockies or the East Coast and the Appalachians, that stuff will peel gold off and redeposit it and resort it. So even though you've been in an area that had gold before, and then when you looked, it didn't have much left and you got it all out, go check again. Because guess what? Anytime you get storms like we're seeing now, it's going to redeposit. It's going to take out banks and take out other high banks and stuff that were there from ancient placers and resort them and move them down just like a giant sluice box. And the riffles are now refilled with new gold. So go check it out. And so when that snow melts, if it melts fast, as in a warming season or a warm rain, we had that happen here in California just last week. They had a lot of snow building up here on the coastal mountains. It was gorgeous. Well, it vanished overnight. And with it, because there was a lot of this rain, just like what we showed, it wasn't cold. It was a warm rain. It dissolved all that snow and it came down with lots of water. So that means not only did the water come down, but the snow melt went down those same streams and just tore everything apart. And there's gorgeous pictures of guys working right now on up on the San Gabriel River, the East Fork of the San Gabriel River. Go look at some of the pictures of the flooding that's going on there. There's a great video on YouTube look up flooding Palm Springs. That was about a week ago. Wow. Talk about water moving in an area that has no water. That's the desert here in California. That's how gold moves. So that's tonight's show. Thanks for joining. I'm glad we got the audio sorted out. I will punch the other video out and we'll just start over again with this one. Anyway, thanks for joining again and thanks for sticking with me through the thick and thin of the technology of gold prospecting. So let me know what you think. And like I said, like the page on Facebook, subscribe to my YouTube video channel, Prospector Jess, and share these things and like them like crazy. Both of those platforms like to know that I am generating as much attention as I am. And the more you guys do that, the more we get a community. And that's what we're about here, engagement and community together to find more gold. Prospector Jess, over and out, huntingforgold.com. Again, take a look at the 2020 offer. And I'll have a link below or above, somewhere in there. And let me know what you think. Catch you then. Prospector Jess, good night.